Hello to all students. I am Professor Masood Fuzail. Today we are going to study phylum Platyhelminthes. If we look at the meaning of Platyhelminthes, platy mean flat and helminthes mean worms. These animals, these are flat worms. So that is why we call this phylum, phylum Platyhelminthes. First of all, we are going to look at the main characteristics of phylum Platyhelminthes. If we look at the characteristics of phylum Platyhelminthes, there are 20,000 species of phylum Platyhelminthes found in the world. They range in size from 1 millimeter to 25 meter. If we look at the diagram of plain area, they could reach up to 1 millimeter and up to few centimeter, but there are certain other animals of this phylum which can reach up to 25 meter, like tapeworm. They have parenchyma, which is a third layer formed in the animal kingdom, which is known as parenchyma and which we will discuss in the later on. This phylum contains four classes which we are going to discuss in separate lectures. First class is Turbellaria, the second class is Monogenia, third class is Trematoda, and the fourth class is Cestodia. These animals are dorso-ventrally flattened, just like my hand. This hand has a dorsal surface and a ventral surface, and this is compressed. So these animals are worms which are dorso-ventrally compressed, just like a leaf. They are also known as triploblastic animal because their body contains three layers of the body: ectoderm, endoderm, and mesoderm. They are acelomates because they do not have body cavity. They are bilateral symmetrical. As you know that bilateral symmetrical are those animals which can be divided into two equal halves which are mirror image to each other in only one plane. If you want to cut this animal into two halves, you can only do it only in one plane. So that is why these animals are called bilateral symmetrical. These are unsegmented worms and they are hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodite mean they have both sexes in the same animal, and they also known as monoecious. These are the major characteristics of phylum Platyhelminthes. Now we are going to discuss the first class of phylum Platyhelminthes, which is known as Turbellaria. Class Turbellaria is also known as Turbellarian because they produce turbulence in the water. When they move in the water, they produced a kind of opaqueness in the water. That is why we call these animals Turbellaria, due to the presence of cilia on their ventral surface. The best example of Turbellarian is Planaria, as you can see in this diagram. First of all, we are going to discuss few different functions of Turbellarians, which include Planarian. And they are free living animals which live in fresh water as well as in marine water. They range in size from 1 millimeter to several centimeter. Their body wall structure, as you can see in this diagram, this animal, I have take a piece of this animal and make a cross section of this animal. This is the anterior side and this is the posterior side. In the cross section, this side is dorsal and the other side is ventral. If you look at the diagram, the layer of the cell which is present outside the body, outermost layer, is known as epidermis, which is also known as ectoderm. The innermost layer, which you can see in the green color, that is gastrodermis and also known as endodermis. This gastrodermis contains gastric cavity, and in between ectoderm and endoderm there is a cavity which is filled by acellular material which is known as parenchyma. So this is the third layer. That is why we call these animals triploblastic: epidermis, endodermis, and parenchyma, which is the third layer. These animals do not have body cavity. That is why they are called acelomate. These animals contain circular muscle, longitudinal muscles, and dorso-ventral muscles. Circular muscles are arranged in the circumference of the body, and longitudinal muscles are arranged along the length of the body. While muscle, you can see right over here in the diagram in the red section, these are dorso-ventral muscles which are connected with dorsal side to the ventral side. Inside the epidermis or ectoderm, there are some cells which are known as rhabdoid cell. As you can see in this diagram, these rhabdoid cells are produce some kind of mucus secretions which helps to attach these animal with the surface or de-attach the animal from the surface. On the ventral side, you can see cilia, many cilia present on the lower side, which helps in the locomotion of these animals. So this is the cross section of these animals and body wall structure. Now we are going to discuss digestive and nutrition function. These animals are herbivores, carnivores, and scavengers. Some animals eat algae, they are herbivores. Some eat animals like small crustacean or small animals, bacteria, etc. They are known as carnivores. And some animals which eat dead particles of dead animals, these are known as scavengers. On the ventral side, there is present a mouth. Mouth is an opening through which their eversible pharynx can comes out. Just behind the mouth there is a pharynx which is eversible, it can be protruded out just like our tongue. When a food particle attaches with the surface of the pharynx, they take back the pharynx into their digestive cavity. Behind the pharynx there is a digestive cavity which is divided into three canals. The first canal is going on the interior side of the body, while two are going on the lateral and posterior side of the body. Inside these digestive cavity, food is partially digested and larger food particles are digested into smaller food particles with the help of enzyme. These cavities are divided into further small cavities and distributed to all over the body. Remaining digestion, it takes place inside the cell, which is known as intracellular digestion, while the extracellular digestion takes place in the digestive cavity. After digestion of the food, food is absorbed inside the body and assimilated in different parts of the body. After assimilation, undigested material which is excreted through digestive cavity and through pharynx into the mouth. So these animals only have single opening for ingestion and egestion. So that is why their digestive system is known as sac type digestive system. Next system we are going to discuss is nervous system. If we look at the diagram of this planaria has two regions, anterior region which is also known as head and posterior region. Anterior region contain two eyes which are known as eye spots or ocelli. These contain black depressions inside which contain cilia and are used to detect light. So they move away from the bright light. So these eyes are important for detection of light. And the anterior region of the body, there are cerebral ganglia present inside this region which act as like brain. And there are two auricles on the sides of the head which are sensory in function. From cerebral ganglia, two nerves arise which are, as you can see in this diagram, these are longitudinal nerves which runs from anterior region to posterior region. And from these longitudinal nerves arise lateral nerves on the sides of the body. And to connect these two longitudinal nerves, there are also main nerves which are known as commissure nerves which attach these two longitudinal nerves. So in this way, their nervous system looks like a ladder. With help of nervous system, they can detect various type of chemicals and light and different stimulus which are coming towards them. And in the head region, there is also a stratosis which help in the detection of gravity. The next system we are going to discuss is excretory system. This is the animal where first excretory system is present, which is also known as protonephridium. Proto mean first form, nephridium mean kidney. So these are the first animals of animal kingdom which have regular that excretory system. If we look at the excretory system of the animal, this is a diagram of the planaria and has branch like structure inside their body. I have taken a small piece of these branches and shows you in the diagram. This system is known as protonephridium. It consists of cells which are bulb-like cells which are known as flame cells. These cells are known as flame cell because they have tuft of cilia which vibrates with the help just like a which flicker just like a flame of a candle. So that is why we call them flame cell. They contain nucleus, cytoplasm. When the tuft of cilia beat inside the flame cell, the waste material from the interstitial fluid gets into this cavity of the cell, and from here it is excreted into the tube which is known as excretory tube. All the excretory tubes of the excretory system where the waste material is collected and thrown out of the body through an opening which is known as nephridiopore. So in this way, whole digest excretory material, waste material, nitrogenous material of the body is excreted via protonephridium or phloem cell. These animals do not contain a respiratory or circulatory system. Gaseous exchange place through general body surface. The next system we are going to discuss in Tribularian is the reproductive system. These animals reproduce asexually as well as sexually. If we look at the asexual reproduction of animal, these animals divide by binary fission. This, as you can see, this is a planaria. It is going to divide into two animals. The first of all, a constriction ring is formed in the middle of the animal. This constriction gets increased and animal divides into two other animals. As you can see in this diagram, this planaria has been divided into two other animals. Each part will develop new systems inside their body. So in this way, through asexual reproduction, binary fission, one animal divides into two animals. They also do sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction, they are hermaphrodite and monoecious. Monoecious and hermaphrodite means they contain both sexes in the same animal. I have made a diagram for you. This diagram contains both system, male system and female system. First of all, we are going to look at the male reproductive system. As you can see in this diagram, the blue system, as you can in the diagram you see, these are male reproductive system. It consists of testes. As you know, that testes are male gonads which produce sperms. As these are testes in the blue color, it right here on the this side also has testes which produce millions of sperms. These sperms are transported through sperm duct into the seminal vesicle, where sperms are stored and then transferred with the help of penis into the other planarian body. If we look at the female reproductive system consists of ovaries. Two ovaries are present on the dorsal side of the body, and these ovaries are known as female gonads which produce eggs. These eggs are transported via a duct which is known as oviduct. As you can see, one duct is over here and one duct on this side. These are oviducts. These oviducts contain some glands which are known as yolk glands or vitellaria, which produces yolk for the eggs. These openings open into the outside. So usually they can do self-fertilization because they are monoecious, but usually the rule is that they reproduce by cross-fertilization. Two animals, two planaria, come across each other and they insert their penis in each other. The one animal insert its penis into the other animal and other insert its penis on this animal. There is a genital pore through which penis is inserted into the body, and sperms are released into the genital chamber. Copulatory sacs. The sperms are stored in copulatory sacs, from where these sperms are transported into the oviduct and sperm reach toward ovary, where they fertilize egg. After fertilization of the egg, egg move through oviduct, and there is yolk is stored inside the egg after fertilization. These eggs are transported into the genital chamber, from where they are excreted from genital pore into the outside of the body. Usually eggs are laid in a cluster and they are protected by a shell which is known as cocoon. Single eggs are not laid, but the eggs are laid in a cluster which are enclosed in a shell which is known as cocoon. There are two types of cocoon: autumn cocoon and spring cocoon. Spring cocoon, because they are laid in the spring season, so they can hatch into miniature adults after 2 to 3 weeks. But autumn cocoon has to stay dormant for whole winter so that they can withstand the freezing temperature of the water. When spring arrive, these cocoon, the eggs are develop into embryo and embryo develop into larva. Usually some animals produce Müller's larva, which is ciliated larva which swims for some time in the water and after that settles on and develop into a new Tribularian or a planarian animal. So in this way, today we have studied Platyhelminthes and its class Tribularia and its different functions. I hope you have understood this topic. If you do, please like it, subscribe it and share with your friends, and we'll see you in the next lecture. Bye.